Before we even start talking about color correcting and color grading, pro tip, get it right in camera. As much as you can, guys, it's important that you get your exposure right, get your white balance right, get your composition right in camera. Believe me, it will save you time and it will give you better result in post-production. Let me know in the comment section if you want me to do a video on how to do that in camera, and subscribe so you don't miss any of that good stuff. Yeah, but today let's talk about color adjustments in post. So the process works like this. When you do your color adjustment in post, you go through a color correction process first, and then you can add a color grade, or simply put, you can add a look that helps you tell your story. The key word when you color correct your project is accuracy. You want the colors and the exposure to be accurate. Let's look at this example really quick. This was shot in S-Log 2 at 120 frames per second. It's a log footage, so it's very flat. There is no saturation, there is no contrast. Okay, so there are several ways to add contrast, and I feel like that can be another video by itself, but for now, change your workspace to your color grading workspace. And if you don't have one saved yet, I'll link a video right up here that will show you how to do that. You can also go to color and effects, and we want to see the luma waveform. That's what we want to see. So make sure that the luma waveform is there and make sure that the units is on IRE. I personally like to use the color wheels for this process. So let's lift the highlights until the brightest part in the clip gets close to 100. You know, some people say never go over 100 because you will lose information in your highlights. It will be too bright. It will be overexposed. And yeah, that's kind of like the general rule. But the truth is, there are times when you choose to go over 100 as a creative because you don't mind losing some information in some highlights, like when you shoot the sun, for example. I mean, you don't need information in the sun. But for now, here in this one, we're going to stay right around 100 for the brightest part on the helmets. And then we're going to bring down the shadows. We're going to bring the shadows down to around zero, or just before you lose information in the darkest area of this clip. Here is the trick to add more contrast in your footage. If you drag down this mid-tone wheel right here, you will actually notice that we're starting to have more contrast in the footage. And again, that's just one way to add contrast. There are multiple ways. But yeah, it's pretty cool that you can just do that and you add more contrast. Now that we worked on the exposure, let's deal with the color in this clip. Let's add saturation. Of course, there is multiple ways to do this, but you can add another color wheels and lift the left side of the global wheel to add saturation. You can play around with it, of course, but don't overdo it. Actually, you can also scroll down here and use the mix slider to control the amount of the effect. When you color correct, you also need to work on the white balance. And I've made a couple of videos on how to do that, but here is the quick version right here. Add balance color to your clip by going here or Option Command B, and then in your video inspector, choose the white balance and then click on anything that is supposed to be white. And there you go. Subtle, but nice. If you guys get any value from this video, go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.